Do you know the answer to this?
Can you spell your name for me?
You also gave an answer. Good job.
In Beaufort County School District, we serve more than 22,000 students. 2,082 of those students are special needs, and a number of them use assistive technology.
Assistive technology is a service that we provide to our students so they're able to access the general ed curriculum, able to communicate with their peers.
We have varying tools that range from eye gaze devices and bars to actually iPads that we use for AAC devices.
In Beaufort County, we're very fortunate that we have devices for all of our students. In our early childhood special ed classes, we have devices, iPads for them to access. And in the elementary, middle, and high school, it's of the teacher's choosing.
What makes our district unique is we've developed a team that works collaboratively to make sure that all the devices are working for the students, that we have networks that will support the devices, and that we have a coach that will go in and assist teachers to make sure that the devices are used appropriately when it comes to integrating their usage into the curriculum.
And we really strive to make sure that our departments with assistive technology and instructional technology work so closely together, because it's not only valuable for our students' experience, but it's essential to their success.
We've seen growth with them and using these devices as they are able to communicate, access the general ed curriculum, and be able to express to us what their wants and needs and the knowledge that they have as they cannot through their voices.
As a part of our assistive technology program, we have various tools that we use with students.
So CONEMS is a really good program to use kind of multi-sensory learning. They are able to use gross motor and fine motor skills in order to practice the academics that we're working on in the classroom.
And it's accessible to my students with limited mobility, which is really wonderful. It's a really fun way for the kids to interact with their learning materials.
A lot of the children have ADHD, so it kind of helps them to be able to get that energy out and be engaged in the activity rather than sitting in their chair. A lot of the kids also have occupational therapy and physical therapy, so it works on their gross motor and fine motor movements too, so that helps.
The ProLoquo to go gives him a really great way to communicate his wants and needs. It's quick and easy for us to program to add new things he might need to say.
It's touch screen, so she finds the picture that she wants to say, and then she touches it, and she can make a sentence and touch the top, and it says the whole sentence for her.
So anything that's relevant to him or relevant to what we're studying can be added in a matter of seconds, and he's able to let us know what he knows and what he needs, and it really opens up a whole world for him to be able to communicate what is going on inside his head. It's been absolutely wonderful.
Well, the children that need these programs, you have to find the one that's appropriate for them, and every child deserves a voice, and this is a way for us to give them their voice.
By using ProLoquo to go to communicate, Rashad's fine motor skills have also really improved. He's always had a difficult time with finger movements, and he's gotten much more precise, and it's also helped him immensely using his power wheelchair, which is operated by a small joystick. So he's gotten a lot better using that now. He's a lot more accurate, a lot more comfortable.
Show me the candy. Nice.
Teach Town is a program we use for social skills and academic skills.
What is the answer to this problem?
It's a really great program because we can integrate the IEP goals each student has individually onto the program, and we can assign any tasks that we are working on with them, and it also gives a good progression of starting points to ending points on skills. My students are benefiting from it just from their acquisition and generalization of skills. For our kids, it's really hard to generalize those skills out into real life situations. And so I feel like they master the lessons in here, and then they generalize it to other skills that we're working on in our classroom.
That's correct.
Hi. What school do you go to?
I think Milo is relatable for the students with autism because he's got a very soft-spoken voice. He's very, very simple. He explains things realistically.
So Milo is teaching them how to make eye contact. He teaches them how to initiate conversations.
I've noticed her practicing her facial expressions more, stopping and thinking about her words before she says them, phrasing them more in a greeting or more in the ending of a conversation.
Hanna uses the Toby eye gaze device. It's an augmentative communication device that she uses in class and in every aspect of her life.
It has allowed her to be able to express what she knows, all of the thoughts, her needs, her wants, even for educational purposes. She's able to communicate through her eye gaze.
It's an amazing device that uses an eye gaze tracker at the bottom, and then it allows her to select letters or different aspects of the screen in order to manipulate it the same way that IRU would use a computer or a smartphone.
It's amazing. They've got cameras that are located at the bottom of the dynamic display screen, and she will just look and basically type with her eyes on a keyboard and be able to hit a speaker button and be able to communicate. So it has really changed her life.
Hi, my name is Karam. I am in fourth grade. This is my Toby Eye Gaze device.
So it gives a voice to what he wants. At school, I've seen him grow a lot because he's incorporated his academics and using the Toby. So if he can't answer a yes or a no, he can give a definite answer to what is being asked to him.
Hi, welcome to MC Riley Elementary Schools.
Overall, it's been a great experience. He was a greeter for our Leader in Me Day, and he used it to greet all of the adults when he walked into the building and let them know what was going on for the day.
Today is Leadership Day.
Parents are able to send a device from home that can be supported in the school. So a student doesn't have to learn on one device at school and then have to use another device at home.
So I use a personal MacBook, and I use that for pretty much all of my classwork. I use a program called a screen reader, and that basically reads out to me what's on the screen. It's on the Mac.
Word, space, the word, I.
As we move toward the future, we look to build a stronger network to support the devices that our students bring in from home. And not only that, we look to offer more professional development opportunities for parents and teachers on how to more effectively use those devices.
And to always look for the best program to have the students reach their potential.
What else are we going to do today?
Thank you for playing with